Look at the lightning. So beautiful.
Prepare to fight.
Much better than it was.
Round begins in 3, 2, 1, fight.
Let's remove the spectator hint. Oh, Stone gets the heavy spawn and uses his ability with great success. There is some spit though, but he can get to the mega elf in time. Oh, the Sandal Man is so quick. Oh, but he does get a lot of LG. Oh, up go. And he falls. So it's 1-1 with the, well, 30 seconds underway. So we have some entertainment left. Oh, the string of LG from both is strong, but from Stone it's stronger. So he gets the kill. Can stack back up on the light. The heavy is still 10 seconds away, but yeah, he takes position. He really wants to defend it. Oh, he hears the jump pad, so now he's in a split decision. Do I want to do some damage or take the heavy? Well, he just showed that he opts to take the heavy. Oh, and no, he doesn't connect the follow-up. Oh, but no. What is happening? Oh, wow. The lightning gun of Pepka, though. Oh, and Stone walks into a full-on shotgun or starter shotgun blast, but it was enough to delete him. It's really going back and forth. I think the first time it will tone down a bit is if one of the players will get a full rotation. But yes, Stone does not have a pop. No! Lost. I think Stone just put a banana over there or something, because it's the second time Pepco is slipping up. Ah, but this is rough. It was really even in terms of damage and frags, and now Pepco just lost out on a lot. Oh, but Stone isn't collecting the mega health that clean. Well, it's a really dirty pickup because he falls after taking the item. Yeah, now Pepco is outstacking Stone, but oh yeah, he doesn't have enough in his LG, so he switches to rocket. While Stone was just still steady with his lightning gun on his face. So Pepco got melted. But Stone paid a lot of stack for that frag. And well, yeah, he doesn't have a pop 8. Ooh, we almost got another ring out. But Pepco is improving. It still wasn't a perfect... walk, but it's improving. So yeah, items are spawning at the same time, and I think Stone will be content with taking the heavy. Oh, he gets a lot of damage though, that HMG. Oh, but the return is there. Rockets from down below do a lot of damage. Oh, Pepco will fall, but he does a lot of damage to Stone, who's just in time to get to a health bubble to remove the damage over time. But now, yeah, he's in survival mode, and Pepco is aware of it. So he gets the follow-up frag. And, well, yeah, he is time to do some damage on the heavy. Connects a full on Hundi, and he hears the jump pad, so he knows where Stone is... Well, Stone still escapes. Wow, if that would have connected, then it would be awesome. But it doesn't. Pepco. Well, he has to collect some rockets. He doesn't do so. He wants to get the mega health right on acid spawn, so he can do some damage on the heavy. Isn't that successful, but he does stack back up on rocket launcher ammo. So yeah, this is the first time there is some distance between the players. They give each other some room, try to be a little bit more tactical. And it's also that Stone, yeah, is rocking full control right now. So Pepco is a little bit more defensive by default right now. Ooh, his rocket does not connect. He does step off the ledge, so he evades the bull rush, but not the rocket, but oh! Stone rockets himself into the abyss. And it turns out to be a trade. Wow, and now Stone is taking so much damage without doing that much in return. Oh, but he takes a great position to turn it around. And now Pepco is really weak.
I will lead the way.
Well, yeah, well, they both retreat to their own item. Oh, but Pepco not before he's taking a rail. Oh, but he still hasn't enough stack to fight for the mech alpha. Stone almost gets sent into the abyss by that rail. Look at the health Pepco is dealing with. But still, he's able to connect a rocket onto Stone. So it's still anybody's frag at this moment. And Stone, well, he's waiting on this item. If Pepco was aware of the timing, he could certainly punish that move from Stone. But yeah, I think they will both retreat to their own item. Yes, Pepco gets the mega health uncontested. Stone is still shopping for an angle though, but he doesn't get one. It's Pepco who is getting the angle and does a lot of damage. Yeah, yeah. He gets the tying frag. And the mega elf is still far away from spawning. Well, Stone does have his ability, he does a lot of damage. But Pepco got both items, so if he can deny the mega elf, no, Stone is just standing on that item. He knew that Pepco would first collect some poverty items. So, yeah, Stone is back in a healthy fighting condition.
Lost.
He tanks a lot of damage, but his passive gets the kill in the end. That's a skill bearer for you guys. Yeah, he just can walk through all the damage, collecting the mecha health. Does get some spit on himself, but he's quick enough to mitigate it.
Impressive.
The heavy goes to Pepco though. He has a little bit more than a minute to get back in this match. And well, the rocket is a start, but again he slips. What is going on? Yeah, I want to make a joke, but I don't want to. I want to. There is a channel in the Quake Champions. I do it. Hashtag bug report. Oh, this is rough. Yeah, it might be his movement, but there may be still some has some error in the map. But yeah, it's early access, right? Hey, Septic, thanks for the follow. And Joe Greasy, thanks for the follow.
You win.
Yeah, Stone gets it, but I think it was really close. I think we had 5 suicides from Pepco. So next up is Molten Falls, where Stone is rocking Ranger and Pepco has Visor in his pocket. I don't know what they're saying, but I agree. So yes, I think that's the answer. We're losing a player. Stone did not enter the server. Well, this gives me a moment to shove some food in my mouth. Yeah, if somebody's up for another competition, well, I think it's already 8 o'clock, right? Might already start it. Yeah, breakfast is already underway. Again, he's not in the server. What is happening?
The god is near.
I think Pepco doesn't want to play at a particular server. And the same goes for Stone. But yeah, I think Ion will manage it. But I do think there are no exact rules in this tournament about which server should be picked. Let's see. Yeah, okay. The server is selected by mutual agreement of the players. If you cannot agree, choose a server where the minimum ping difference between players and the lowest pings of the players. So, yeah, it's basically the same as the challengers. So if you can't agree on the server, then you have to choose the one with how do you say it? The lowest delta. That's pretty weird that he went back in time. This one is 218 and the next one is 1951. No, it's not really that they're fighting about the server. It's more that Stone, he can't connect to the server. I can show it to you guys. So yeah, this is about the match that he just fell into the hole the whole game. But this is Stone didn't get into the server. And we tried it a couple of times and he still wasn't in the server, so now he's restarting his game. So there is no drama going on. Well, maybe if you think that computer problems is drama, but it's not between the players. So let's see if we already have some extra donation. Yeah, look at that. Another 25 cents and a direct money wire. Or. I was looking at that name, so I thought it is a money wire, but it's just a contribution from MTV Wires. So if you haven't already, you can press the sign-in button, then the contribute button, and then you can use STOTY24 to add 25 cents for free to the prize pool of today. But I hear something going on in-game, so let's see if... yeah, they are searching for the map, and the stone is back. So let's hope that he enters the server this time. Well, at least Stone is having fun.
Prepare to fight.
There we go.
Round begins in.
Three, I think they're both having fun. Two, that's great to see.
One. Fight.
Let's go. So Pepco gets the heavy spot. That means automatically that Stone gets the mega health spawn. Oh wow, Stone uses his orb to enter this fight and his rockets are amazing. But I don't think he has lightning gun to his name. Wow, Pepco uses his ability to great effect. He had a perfect idea where he should have connect his shots. And well, that's also funny. When you use vision and you get the kill, your enemy always explodes. So even if it wasn't full on shotgun blast, Stone exploded anyway. So we got some nice gips from the first frag. Wow, and Pepco even gets the opening damage. While Stone wanted to go around the corner to collect the real gun. But that got denied. And if Pepco, well, yeah, he could have been a bit aggressive with a rocket jump and be in time to do some damage on the heavy. But he doesn't want to gamble anything. He wants to hold on to his lead. Oh, but look at the shot Stone is connecting with the railgun. And he follows it up with the orb. A rocket play.
Watch.
Which gets him on the board and also results in a tie between the both players, which means they have one frag each. Might have to do some administrative work. One frag first. Let me check my message. Yeah, I something in a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah, I'm back. I might be... doing something later. But, wow! Pepco just conquers himself. The mega health mid-fight. And also takes the frag. Oh, Stone uses his orb to escape this fight, but not without doing any damage. Or, yeah, well, he received some. And after that, he connected two rail shots onto Pepco. So this means that he will probably get this mega health. Well, small peppering off the tri-bolt from Pepco. Oh, but that rocket did about the same damage. So, yeah, none of the players really have an in the follow-up frag. And Stone is even being pretty defensive. As soon as he tanks some damage, he doesn't want to continue the fight. And Pepco is already in the lead, so he's fine. But great rail. And a follow-up. He does return some damage, but yeah, this is a signal for Stone to enter the area with the orb. Ooh, he does jump onto a lot of lightning. So Pepco will get the heavy uncontested. Wow, and his snowballs do not connect, while the rail from Stone does connect. Oh, but the follow-up is there. And well, Stone turns this around. Stopwatch. Gets greeted by the mega health, and Pepco has no position on it to do any damage on it. And hoorah! Yeah, as soon as Stone gets some damage, he uses the orb to get up close. And uses the H-ult orb rocket combo. Yeah, to great effect. So yeah, Stone has a good rotation going, but the tri-bolt from Pepco is an opening for the follow-up frag. Yeah, good decision of jumping down with the shotgun. Also punishes the pickup of the mega health to Stone. Yeah, now we have a tribal standoff, and this goes in favor of Stone. So he earns himself the heavy. He had both items. So Pepco is really worse for wear, and especially after dying, he has nothing to wear. Anyway. And Stone takes the lead. It's still some time left, but wow, that honey. On to Pepco. Oh, and his shot does not connect, and he's still lingering out. Stone goes all in with the rocket orb combo, and it pays out. So he gets another one. Or another frag in the lead. Pepco really needs to be present at a major item. Stopwatch. The next minute or so to get back in this game. Well, he is appearing at an item, but he takes damage. And we have the orb again.
Operation is running smooth.
and even before he gets the major item, he gets a frag, so he can stack back up on the item that he left up. Well, Pepco is throwing snowballs around. And it gets him a frag, but he's left water weak. Yeah, Stone already has a lightning gun to his name. Pepco is early on this mega health. So, yeah, his overstack.
1 minute warning.
Or his armor is professionally removed by Stone. And he basically needs the heavy armor to stack back up. He wasn't aware where Stone was, and oh yeah, of course. Stone's Ranger is so effective.
Impressive.
GG. Yeah, I think Exile, in the end, score-wise, it wasn't close because Pepco suicided a lot. So Exile was pretty close, but this one went to Stone by a great margin.